When I was a student, I thought I knew what structural engineers did because I took many design courses. But after being in the industry for almost 4 years now, I've noticed that there's so much we go through as structural engineers that is just not taught in school. That's why we have a special guest today to tell us his experience so that you can better prepare yourself for the industry. Let's go. All right, now the big question, Kyle. What do you hate, or what do you, or what do you not like about structural engineering? It's been almost 4 years for me, but for my friend and coworker Kyle Koughan, it's been 1 year. While it's still fresh in his mind, he's going to tell us his experience as a structural engineer for 1 year. How are you doing, Kyle?
Hey, great. Glad to be here. Thanks for the debut on the channel. Yeah. Excited to share my thoughts with you today.
Great. Well, so why don't you just tell us a little bit about yourself?
I grew up in Florida, and I went to the University of Florida, where I studied civil engineering and graduated in December of 2020. Started working in West Palm Beach with Rômulo in January, and now I've got just about a year under my belt.
Did you do your bachelor's and master's, or just your bachelor's degree?
So no, I just studied with my bachelor's degree at the University of Florida.
And what made you pick civil engineering in the University of Florida and then specialize in structural engineering?
When I was graduating high school, I remember looking at the list of majors offered. There's College of Engineering, College of Business, pre-med, you could go anyway. So I knew from high school that my favorite subjects were always math and science related. I knew that that would probably be the direction that I should go in. It's what I was good at. It's what I like to do. So from there, I kind of narrowed it down to engineering. I knew I wanted to study engineering at UF. And then the question was it going to be civil, mechanical, biomedical, chemical?
Right.
It still didn't narrow it down all the way. But I was always interested with building things as a kid. I liked buildings. I remember being interested by construction sites and playing with Legos and that whole thing. And so from the whole list of engineering majors, civil engineering really caught my eye for that reason. I just started with it. And as I went on, I considered changing a few times. But looking around, there was nothing else that really took my eye away from that. So I went with civil, and then it was time to get more specific, and structural it was.
For me, it was a little bit similar as well. I actually studied in Brazil for half of my degree. And back then, I remember I didn't decide to go for civil engineering until I was in my junior year, actually, in high school. And in Brazil, the main degrees were medicine, civil engineering, and law school. I just also was more familiar with math and physics and was doing better at those disciplines that it was an easy decision for me.
So that's actually interesting because you had a similar experience with me then and enjoying those math courses. And that's actually really important for an engineer to like their math courses, because while there are other aspects of the profession, coordinating with clients, it all really comes back down to that math component. And you're going to be working just uphill if you don't really enjoy running through those numbers and understanding how things work.
Yeah, and it's not like you need to solve derivatives or integrals in your day job, because really the actual math that we use is not that hard. It's not that difficult. We have a bunch of formulas and we don't really need to memorize them, but it's just the sheer fact that you're going to be running numbers almost every day and you're going to be doing some sort of equations and exercising critical thinking in the form of numbers of what works, what doesn't work, how can you take a little bit off of this equation here, put it a little bit there, as long as you're obeying the laws of physics. Mm-hmm. So it's really, I think it makes a lot of sense to point that out, that if you are going to pursue engineering, just evaluate yourself and see if you actually enjoy that subject. So when you were in college, Kyle, what were your expectations? Once you decided to become a structural engineer, what were you expecting? And how did those expectations change now that you've been in the field for 1 year?
Yeah, so it's a lot different from what I expected. I remember being, a senior in college. I've taken all these design courses. I'm doing my senior design capstone class. I do that. I pass that. I graduate. I take the FE. I pass that. And I'm feeling good and ready to take on the world as a structural engineer. I get the job opportunity and I start. And then you go through this training process and you're still feeling good then. And then your first project lands on your lap and you kind of look down and you're like, where do I even begin? So it can be a very intimidating start in a way. Hopefully, if you're with a company where you have people that can help as a resource and training, and most people are willing to help you along the way and show you the ropes. And once you've done it a few times, it gets easier. And every other time after that, it's a little bit of a shock in the very first couple of months, but I found out that it's not too different after all. Another thing that I thought was going to go differently was when a picture of engineering office in my mind, it had a bunch of engineers working together on a building, for example. That's how it was in college with group projects. It was like, all right, I'll take the columns, you take the walls, you take the beams, and then we'll collaborate all together and we'll fit it together somehow. That hasn't been my experience so far. It's been working with a project manager one-on-one pretty much, and they're there for answering questions, support, coordinating with the client, overseeing the progress of the project. But it's really on you as the engineer to design every aspect of the building. I don't know if that's how it works at every engineering office, or different offices have different culture. I don't know if you've had a different experience with that.
Yeah, actually, I was working at a larger firm before as a curtain wall engineer and working on high-rise buildings, actually. So at any given point in time, we could have maybe 4 or 5 engineers working on the same project. So it was slightly more collaborative, but just a different setting, I would say, because I was still taking ownership of that specific task that I was working on. So it's not like we were at a desk and collaborating and, you know, shooting ideas off of each other. It was more like we spent a whole week, if I was working on curtain wall panels of this high-rise building for a third of the building, and someone else was working on just glass design, they did that for a whole week. And then at the end of the week, we sat together like, okay, here are my findings. Here's my progress. Maybe we met throughout the week if we had more questions. But I think it's just a bigger project and a bigger scope of maybe what you've experienced so far. So it is something that I think students should know, that when you're in college, maybe there's a lot more collaboration just because you are literally sitting next to so many more people, and the academic environment is different than the professional, the industry environment. That is just a different scenario, I'd say. All right, Kyle, how about what you love the most about structural engineering?
I've always liked this about civil engineering, and even more specifically structural engineering, is it's such a versatile degree. A lot of degrees and professions, like law school, for example, you need to commit to law school and being a lawyer and know that you love doing that. With a civil engineering degree or a structural engineering degree, it's a lot more options for you. You can go and do design in the office and get really technical. You can go and do coordination with architects and contractors, and you can work indoors in the office or outside in another environment. There's so many different opportunities with a degree like this. And you can even combine them all in one job. Our job, for example, there's days where we're in the office designing. There's days where we're outside talking to people.
Doing inspections.
I really enjoy that flexibility in my day-to-day schedule that I probably wouldn't get at another career path.
Another thing is that going into structural engineering right out of school really helps you understand the technicalities of how to build buildings, how to build certain types of structures. Whereas, let's say if you got out of school and you went for construction, for example, later on, you probably will not transition to structural engineering. Or if you do, it'll be really hard to actually, after say 3-5 years, go to structural engineering, and you're literally going to start from the beginning, learning the codes, learning how to run certain types of calculations. So I think it's a career path that not many people, and I don't know anyone who actually took that career path. Whereas I know several people who were structural engineers first in their careers, and then later on they decided, hey, I don't want to be crunching the numbers anymore. I want to actually go to the field. And they are easily accepted and they can easily get jobs at construction firms.
They're because, preferred sometimes, right?
Yeah, because they know how buildings are built and the numbers that are ran behind the scenes, so they can actually be a great asset for that company.
Yeah, that's something that they forced a lot at university was, if you think that you might like the design world, start there. Because if you start in construction, for example, and you don't use those skills right away, you're going to forget them, and it's going to be a lot harder to come back to that later on.
All right, now the big question, Kyle. What do you hate, or what do you, or what do you not like about structural engineering?
I see you're putting me on the spot here. I'd say it's a tough profession at times. There's a lot that goes into it. There's a lot of work behind the scenes that, honestly, architects and contractors and clients don't fully understand.
Yeah.
Sometimes they're ready to have these deliverables by, you know, such and such day. We need it now. And it's something that you want to take your time on such an important aspect of building safety and making sure that everything stands up. So that's difficult at times. And another thing is that you can't quite learn everything. There's so much technical knowledge that encompasses different materials and different building types, and that it really just takes time, and you have to do it once and twice and 100 times to really understand how it goes, and you just have to be comfortable with the process of letting it take a long time.
Yeah, I agree.
What about you? What do you think? What do you dislike about structural engineering?
Yeah, dislike it all. No, for me, I think it's, you touched a little bit on this, the deadline aspect. Depending on the company you are working for and the office culture, it can be very challenging and very stressful, just how many deadlines you have and how you're expected to meet those deadlines, not only internally, but also from a client perspective, how everyone expects certain milestones to be reached at certain times. To be honest, this is our experience in structural engineering. I'm sure in other professions, if you work in the restaurant industry, if you work in whatever it is, there is stress. There are probably some sort of deadlines. Our industry specifically, I think it's a deadline-based industry in the design world specifically, that you have these milestones you have to always reach. And whenever there are too many, it can become very stressful. And I think what has helped me manage stress, especially around deadlines, is the fact that most of the time, these deadlines are like a hill, that you climb that hill, and then once you deliver the project, then you can breathe again. So it's learning how to balance those stressful times. And it's just like when you have a final project at school. You know, you work your butt off trying to get that project done, and then afterwards you go hang out with friends and you go have a good time. So just understanding that, yes, there will be stressful times, and as long as you have a good work-life balance, you should be fine. I think we touched a little bit on these points already, but what advice would you give to someone who is planning to go for structural engineering, or maybe is just starting out in their career?
One thing that's helped me, I think, the most along the way is not being afraid to ask questions. Whether that is to your supervisor, your colleague, even the architect when you're coordinating with them.
Yeah.
Get in the habit of asking a lot of questions. You'll thank yourself later on when you're trying to remember and everyone's busy and you don't remember exactly how to do something or how a certain project is supposed to lay out. So get in the habit of asking questions and use the resources of other people in the office as best your ability, because the thing we don't have when we're new is experience, and there should be a lot of that to go around. So hopefully you have people that are helpful and able to share that with you. Do you have any advice for the people?
Yeah, for me, I think, as I mentioned before, it's such a technical profession, structural engineering. A lot of students, at least when I started, I thought I also knew so much about structural engineering because I was doing well on some structural engineering exams in school. But in reality, we don't know so much. So I would say, on top of what Kyle said, also studying, whether it's for your FE if you have not taken it yet, or your PE exam if you want to take it early, and you can check out my video here on why I think you should take it early. But that's something that helped me a lot was just preparing for an exam or doing some study on my own, because that really helped me perform better at work. And it's not like I felt like I was working for free for the company because I'm studying this topic that I should learn at work and other people should teach me necessarily. It's more of a professional and personal development that you do to yourself, because whether you stay with this company or you move on to a different company, that knowledge stays with you and no one can take that away. So I think it's something really important, and it's also easier to do earlier on in your career because you don't have 5 kids or other obligations in your life, perhaps.
Yeah, definitely subscribe to Quick Question Engineering for all your FE and PE tips. This man knows it all.
There you go. I don't, but subscribe anyway. This wraps it up for this first interview on the Quick Question Engineering channel. I hope you enjoyed it. Kyle is actually in the process of launching a baseball channel. So once it's fully launched, the link will be in the description below. So make sure you go check it out. That's all for today.
And see you next time.
So make sure you go check it out.
Yeah, thanks. It's the least you can do.